just a simple idea. Even I don't know why I was selected. the short story is that I had a bicycle, an expensive bicycle, and it was stolen. And then I tried to find a very decent one, not so pricey. And I tried the company that everybody knows that it was the most well-known bicycle in Romania in the ex-communist time. And they say they closed the line. And then I read an article that they were saying that their license for the brand expired. And then I started the process to register this brand. And now I have the mission to revive this bicycle brand, which is very, very low for head-on. Okay. So I started to document, to build a team with a designer, an engineer, and a marketing guy. And we redesigned the bicycles to our base and to the segment, to the population segment that is very close to these memories. And we came up with some new models. They will be ready in May, but this season. And we think we can use this brand as an umbrella for the urban creativity from people that have nice ideas in the bicycle the design or in the textile line, like this T-shirt I made in the last 2 days of thinking. And we got a lot of support from media and from advertising companies that are offering us free creation, free advertising and free creation solutions. And also from the companies, so we were contacted by big companies to sell them as promotions. And as an online solution, we were thinking to use a online configurator, which is the trendiest thing now in bicycle business. To configure different parts, different colorful parts, different accessories, and start with personalized solutions.
Great design, I have to say, both on the pitch as well as kind of the actual bikes. We really like it. And I mean, you focus a little bit on online in the end, and kind of that's most of the background here, right? But I think there's a huge trend right now of two ways. I mean, the first one is the customization and mass customization. So I'm invested in one company that does customized suits and shirts and really has production facilities in China, so you can get it really made to measure. And you know, in the past that was always very expensive, but now with modern production technology and an online interface where you can help give the order. Everything that is on mass customization of products is a very interesting area. So from that point of view, I think, you know, while you focus on the bike, I think even the online aspect is a very interesting one of leveraging online to get customization of products. And that, I mean, kudos for the design, looks great. I would buy one.
Thank you very much.
So we sell this.
Do you actually have the brand?
Yes.
You register the brand?
Mm-hmm. For bicycle and for textiles.
Okay. Where's the designer? This nice one.
Sorry?
Where's the designer?
It's one of our co-founders. His name is Ciprian Funzan. You can find him online. Yeah. He has a project.
Are these bikes real or computer generated?
Sorry?
The bikes are real or computer generated?
No, it's 3D Max.
Okay.
But very close to the real image. We have some samples in March in the bicycle brand. Yes.
So we actually sell these bicycles.
We will sell them in May.
What is the price point?
Price.
The price is like 250 euros.
Okay, thank you. What is the normal bike here?
It started from like 100 euros to 2000.
Okay.
So we are in the low medium segment.
And how big is biking in Romania in general or Bucharest?
It's very much growing. The market is like 250,000. Pegas had an average of 300,000 bicycles per year. And it's really growing and the infrastructure is growing. And
I was just curious about, I think it's beautiful. And when I was a little kid, I wanted a bike and this was the expensive one and I got a stupid one. And I always wanted one. Right now I have the same feeling, you know, since I was a kid. And I think it's a great opportunity that you find. So it's more like the product is great. It's not necessarily a product question. I wanted to ask about this experience with the brand, because I've seen last year, I think there is this ice cream brand called Bola, and it reappeared, and I love that ice cream as well, and I don't know who's managing it, who's doing it, and so. And you took over the Pegas, which is like an icon for one or two generations, let's say. In this experience, did you end up to talk with the old company that was producing this, or with the initial origin? I cannot notice that the design is very similar to, it's like a facelift, right, or an upgrade, it's a 2012 design of the old Pegas, right? Did you get in touch with the original designers or anything like that?
Not really, but we got in touch with some engineers from the factory, and when we will get enough of financing, definitely we will open
a vintage factory.
Was it a state company?
Yeah, it is a state company.
It is a
it's building army products. Okay. And they dropped it on the bicycle line because in 2000 it was a very big competition because we were a very low income country, so there came one or two Chinese assemblers and they just really compete with this company and they got broke with the line. But now the income is at least five times more. And I was speaking with people from these Chinese companies and they are really understood that the market is not willing to buy any more cheap things, cheap low quality things. Mm-hmm. And also we are in discussion with them, but I hope not to agree with them.
So for customization, this bicycle is the same price, 250 euro?
Yes, but for the first season we will not be able to offer the customization because of the number of the of the sets available. We will have like 560, we order 560 pieces. It will be difficult to, but we're still thinking.
So you have an investor to product this bicycle right now?
I invested myself. I found a partner that I could leverage my money. That, for example, I found one partner in Europe who can store this bicycle and sell it to me at 100 pieces per time. So I just pay in advance. He paid for everything, and I just pay for each transport of 100 pieces.